there's faces on this wall that their loved ones are calling and they're just not going to pick up the phone.
Hurricane Ian killed at least 59 people in Lee County, and now people are paying tribute to some of the victims. Volunteers created this memorial in downtown Fort Myers to honor those lost. It's been growing for a couple of days now.
NBC2's Joshua Cole talked to people who are stopping by.
This wall here in downtown Fort Myers is more than just a memorial for the people we lost during Hurricane Ian. It's also a sign of hope that we might find some people still missing.
It's gut-wrenching just to see this. I mean, this right here is what people really need to see, is this wall.
Surrounded by a washed-up marina and debris scattered through Centennial Park, the Wall of Hope stands out. Surfside resident Leo Soto made it as a place for people to remember friends and family.
All these letters, these flowers, it's emotional, but it shows that people care.
We met Heather Cox, who's lived in Fort Myers all her life, reflecting at the wall.
These people have no idea where these family members or friends are, or if they're even alive. But I see the pictures of all the animals down there. I see the pictures of the humans. It's just heartbreaking, all of it.
There's faces on this wall that their loved ones are calling and they're just not going to pick up the phone and they could be missing. The worst case scenario, we don't know those answers.
After helping others in need, Crystal brought her boys as a teachable moment.
You bring them here and you show them that they don't have homes. There's people that just don't have it or food.
The artist hopes others will contribute to the memorial as Southwest Floridians come together.
This stuff is replaceable. Lives aren't.
In downtown Fort Myers, I'm Joshua Cole, NBC2.